And the way to avoid stupid choices in the algorithm. Actually, we can make Alice a little bit more happy because we're soon going to show her that we're not going to make her totally happy, but at least neutral, because we're now going to show her a better technique than brute force. And that better technique is known as a search tree. And you will soon see why it's called a tree. So if you were solving vertex cover by yourself, you would probably take the following approach. You would not say for all vertices together if they are in the vertex cover or not, but rather you would look at a single vertex, say this one here, and then split into two possibilities. In one, you're going to say, yes, let's make this vertex part of the vertex cover. In the other one, you would say, no, I do not want this vertex to be part of the vertex cover. And then you're going to split down further. So on this side here and on this side here. So let's look at this vertex here next. And we're just going to draw it a little bit smaller so that we don't run out of space. So we already know that this vertex here is in the vertex cover. And we're now deciding for this vertex here on the left. So we'll have one case where we do put it into the vertex cover and another one where we don't put it into the vertex cover. And then for each of these cases, again, we can split into two possibilities. And this time we're going to look at the vertex down here, same here. So one case where we put it into the vertex cover and another case where we don't. Now here, for this case already, we can stop. We have found a solution of size 3. All edges are covered. We do not even need to consider the possibilities for this vertex here. Over here, we still have to consider two possibilities. So we still need to make a decision here on the right side. So we can either put it into the vertex cover or not put it into the vertex cover. And so the solution here, or it's not a solution because it's not valid. And here again, we have found a solution of size 3 or a vertex cover of size 3. So I'm just going to leave this check mark here and have this count for both. So now we still have to continue here for these four points where we left off earlier. And again, we're going to do the same thing. So we're going to consider one possibility where this vertex down here is not in the vertex cover. And again, we see, whoops, this is invalid. So we do not need to continue any further. Next time, we're going to put this vertex into the vertex cover. And yes, we have a valid solution of size 2. Continuing over here, we're going to consider this vertex here again. So one possibility would be to not put it into the vertex cover, but that is already invalid. And another one would be to put it into the vertex cover, which again leaves us two further possibilities to check, and we're going to check them for this one down here. So same game, invalid solution over here, still valid over here, and need to consider two more cases. And you already know that this case here is going to be invalid. And over here, we're finding a solution of size 3. So that's not bad. Originally, we had, with brute force, 16 assignments of 0 and 1 to the vertices that we needed to check. And now this algorithm here only considered 9 assignments. So I told you at the beginning of this course that constant factor speedups probably don't matter that much when we're dealing with exponential time algorithms. So we will have to do some further analysis on this one. And you also notice that there could be certain other techniques that we can use for a speedup. So for example, here we had already found a solution of size 2. So we probably could have even stopped our algorithm a little bit earlier over here, but we're going to get into this. The main thing that I would like you to understand is the technique of the search tree. And we're now going to analyze this search tree further and try to improve it. And of course, I should also tell you why it is called a search tree. And to show you this, draw lines along where the algorithm was searching. And then we're going to rotate this picture by 180 degrees. And now here you can see a beautiful tree with the solution as the leaves or the fruit or whatever you will. But this is why it's called a search tree. It's basically a tree that hangs upside down. I don't know what the terminology tells you about computer scientists, but that's not my concern here.